Let's take a look at futures. We're seeing a down market, but just barely so. Again, the markets are trying to digest great news on vaccines and therapeutics with regard to COVID. Balance that with the bad news about more lockdowns around the country, from the West Coast to the mid sections of the states, all the way over to New York City. Let's bring in market watcher David Bonson on all this. David, you say the virus and lockdowns are not a major concern for markets. Make your case.
Yeah, I've been trying to point out that all summer long we had this resurgence in Ford, Arizona, Texas, and the market went up 3,000 points.
That's
every
true.
Bit of bad news around the virus didn't move markets. Now we have another kind of surge here of new cases over the last several weeks. The market is up another 3,000 points since October 30th. And I think it's the same reason in both cases, David. It's that the markets know what many of us know, that apparently the governors of California and New York don't know, which is that we can live with this virus, take the precautions necessary to protect the vulnerable, and we do not have to destroy the economy, and especially the most vulnerable people in the economy, in order to do what we have to do.
David, I agree with you 100% that that's the correct analysis of what's happening, but they're locking down anyway. And in New York, there are a lot of people, we're going to be talking to restaurateurs, Zane Tankel and others, who are really concerned, who have to live by the rules that they dictate.
Yeah, that's right. And so I'm not suggesting that they're not people or economic actors that are suffering from their poor policy decisions. But when you talk about the market and the broader market ramifications, it's quite clear it isn't damaging the larger market forces. But on a micro level, it's very much hurting restaurants, small
Absolutely.
Businesses, more targeted areas in big cities. And so there's kind of a distinction here between the macroeconomic impact and some of the micro impact. The micro impact, tragically, is hurting very vulnerable people.
And by the way, a lot of people are worried about big tech, but you think the fact that big tech is losing some of its glimmer is good news, quickly.
Yeah, it's overpriced, and I think it's a misallocation of capital, and you need to see a wider market participation like we're getting right now, more areas of the market participating in the market rally.